This power supply is from a Samsung 19-inch monitor. As you can see here, 20 watts, and Samsung, the model number AD2014B, and we have the connector here. And the output is 14 watts, 1.43 amp. So it is broken. And there's no way to open it rather than cut it open. So I have cut it open here, just along the side, cut it open. After I cut it open, this is what left. So since this one, this inductor dropped for the EMI filter, and this one loose, that's what I have got. But if we look at the parts, it looks good, and the PCB, the color still very fresh, not baked. I seems still repairable. This filter is easy to repair, and that's not a big problem. So now let's have a look of the component layout. So we have here, this is the main input here. And after this, we have this as a fuse, and we have the EMI filter parts. So we have this capacitor, it's the inductor, and after this EMI filter, and we have this bridge. This is a bridge, it consists of a four diode inside. So after bridge, we have this big capacitor, and we can also see here, this is the power management chip. This is a very big one. We have some diode, we have a capacitor, and a power management. We have this transformer, and this would be driven by the power management chip. And we have some diode here. We have a capacitor for the DC output. And another part over here, this is the optocoupler from the secondary feedback to the primary, and actually to the power management chip. From this side, we can see we have got some inductor, some capacitor, fuse, a power management chip, optocoupler, capacitor, diode, and we do not have any resistor on this side. So that I think we would have some resistor on the other side of this printed circuit. Just let's have a look. Now I have got the printed circuit board out of the bottom case, so we can just have a look of the other side. Okay, other side looks pretty good as well. On this side of the board, we can also see some capacitors, some resistors over here, but we also have a three-legged component here. So this one, we got three legs. And we have another one, we got three legs. This three leg thing, it seems like used as a two leg. These two legs also connected together. So I think it's repairable, and we're going to try to find what the problem with this. So what are the problems? So I found out this one, this is the inductor for the EMI filter. And it's a three connection broken, and also this plastic should be plastic together with this tool also broken off. So we just take it away. This is for the filtering. The power supply will work without it. Of course, if you can find a good one, you can replace it. But I think you can just connect this and this, connect this and this, it should be fine. Another thing is this one. This is, see, you can see here, it's a TVR, it's a varistor, so it is broken off. So you can see it just broken off from the printer circuit. So this part is just for protection, the transient voltage, the voltage spikes. So this is just for protection, and we can just try to scrap here and make them using solder and resolder them again to the board, so that should be okay. So what I'm thinking is, so we can weld this on, and we can connect here and here, here and here, without using this. It should work, because we can see this fuse still okay. So there's no overcurrent in this circuit. Maybe because the power supply dropped and this broken off. And this broken off doesn't matter, but this broken off, the power supply will stop working. So I think that's the problem. We're going to connect this pair and this pair, and just solder this back on. It should be okay. So now this power supply repaired and come back work again. And here, this is dropped off. We just shorted these two tabs, we just shorted them to replace this at a minute. And also, we have got this varistor TVR back. And we also, by measuring the terminal of the output cable, we found short, and finally it was this one of the diode, output diode, short. This one is still okay. The two diodes work in parallel and each provide a 2 amp current. Now the only thing left is that now there's only one diode, it will provide less capacity. So we're going to find another diode to replace this and soldering back again. So basically this is repaired. We're just waiting for another diode and then it will back to work for the Samsung monitor. Thank you.